And I've got this Facebook page, and it's called Free Organic Gardening Club Foraging Group on Facebook. So that's the actual page. Okay, so here's the description. Share organic seeds, share organic cuttings, share information on foraging, share information on curing illness through diet and herbs, share information on chemical-free products for body and home, share information on organic gardening, share information on off-the-grid living, share information on pictures of earthships, share information on creating your own cheap electricity, etc., and help food banks. So anything like that. I'm against chemtrails, GMOs, etc. So yeah, just get in contact, and you know, together I'm sure that we can sort of make a difference. I've actually lost 2 stones since January 2015. It's now September 2015, and I didn't even know I was going to lose the weight. Otherwise I've done a before and after photograph. I actually got up to 10.5 stone, and I'm only about 5'2" because I've actually shrunk with age. So I've actually come off my inhalers. I've been on my inhalers since July, but it's been on and off all year because of this vegan diet, which is just amazing. And I've found out so much about different herbs and things that have helped my asthma and my daughter's asthma. I mean, last year we both came off our inhalers by just drinking stimulant tea for 2 months that was, you know, it's growing in the garden. So it's pretty interesting what you can find out, you know, from YouTube. YouTube's an amazing place where you can just find so much information. So yeah, so I just really want to sort of get into this organic growing and try and get a greenhouse somehow, and start growing lots of organic tomatoes. I've grown potatoes, lots of different things I'll show you later on in this video. So I'd love to talk to other people that are growing organic stuff or into the organics, because I think there's a real health benefit there, but we need to get the prices down. I think this website would really help. If we had a free website to help families earn from home with no fees, it's going to help us be healthier, have a better lifestyle, more money in the bank, and, you know, give our children the life they deserve. So yeah, so that's all from me again. I'm saying goodbye again. So I might cut this video a little bit, so I've only said goodbye once, but anyway, you can never get too many goodbyes, can you? That's all from me. Leave me a comment. Sharon here from Butterfly Lullaby. Okay, bye-bye. Along the sides, what I'd like to grow is some wild strawberries. So I'm going to put more hay down here from the rabbit's cage. As you can see, we've got a lot of rabbits, so we've got a lot of hay. And I'd love a greenhouse just here. A nice big greenhouse just here. So if anybody's throwing any greenhouses out, I live in Swansea, and you know, I'd be happy to share the first year's crop with you, because I'm sure that I can grow lots of wonderful tomatoes if I had a greenhouse. So yeah, get in contact with me. I don't know if I'm going to bother doing a potato patch next year, because I found it quite hard work and I didn't get a lot back from it. I don't know if I'm very good at it. I think I'm better at growing tomatoes and strawberries if I've got a greenhouse. So that's something I'd like to concentrate on. So I'd like to probably get a greenhouse there, and, you know, maybe a couple of greenhouses here. Hi, my name's Sharon. I'm from Butterfly Lullaby, and this year I tried to grow some organic foods for the very first time. And I did have some success, but I really, really need some greenhouses, because I am having a real problem with slugs. So here's my lovely rare seed tomato plant. I know I could have had a fantastic harvest from this, because I grew loads and loads of them, but, you know, I had trouble with, I didn't want to put them outside, so a lot of them died off. I put some on the trampoline, but it's been too late. But, you know, I've got a lovely crop here. And what I've been doing is I've been using, there's a video on YouTube saying how to feed them with eggshells. So you put the eggshells in the liquidizer, try and get organic eggshells if you can. Stick them in the blender with some distilled water and just feed them. I don't know, I've tried to feed mine sort of when I've got them. I mean, ideally probably once a week,
if you can. Probably need to look into it anyway. So I'm just starting out, so I don't really know. I mean, maybe you don't need to feed them that much. So, yeah, it's looking good. I've already had one of these. My daughter tried it, and she absolutely loved it. She doesn't like tomatoes, so it says it's a really good variety. And so here's some of my other tomato plants. One. It's really funny, isn't it, that this one's huge, yet there are hardly any tomatoes on it. There's only two, if I come down here, there's only two tomatoes, as you can see here, and it's not really flowering. I think we've got some flowers coming up here, but I mean, it's September now, so it's getting quite late. But this one, you know, the skinny one, it's got hardly any soil in it, and it's a smaller pot. It's got more. It's quite funny, isn't it? Well, this is my first ever homegrown tomato. I'm just about to taste it. That tomato is absolutely amazing. It's sweet and tangy. Oh my gosh, delicious. Really delicious. And here's the wild strawberry. As you can see here, they're absolutely miniature. They're really tiny. It's a rare seed. But my daughter tried. We did have a ripe one. I've got the video. And she loved it. She said it's the best strawberry she's ever tasted, even though it's really tiny. So it'd be wonderful to get some big pots and just try and get a really good harvest from these. It's flowering there, so there's going to be a nice little strawberry there coming as well. And I'd love to get hold of some wild strawberry seeds. I believe they're small like this, so maybe this is a wild strawberry seed. I've actually run out of seeds now because I sort of put them all in plant pots and put some out in the garden, which I wish I hadn't done. So if anybody's got any wild strawberry seeds, I'd love to hear from you. Leave me a comment. Here's a big organic apple tree. It's a cooking apple, and I've actually started making some yeast from these apples, and it's a really wonderful, I've never done this sort of stuff before, so it's really wonderful experience to see the bubbles coming up and it actually making the yeast. So I'd love to share that video with you. Now, if anybody in the Swansea area in the UK, in Wales, would like to trade some of these apples for something else, I'd love to hear from you. The mistake I made this year was I planted too many different plants. I should have just concentrated on just a few. So I'm going to just concentrate on the tomatoes. If I can get hold of some free greenhouses, I'm going to concentrate on just the tomatoes and the strawberries, the rare seeds. And then share my crop with whoever gives me the greenhouse. So I'd like to try and get about three if I can fit them in the garden. So that's popcorn here. It's called black popcorn. It's an organic sort of GMO free rare seed, but I don't think I'm going to get anything from it. I did try putting them in the ground. They got eaten by the slugs, so that is a real problem. So I don't think I'll really bother with that next year. My poor sunflowers, I was really hoping to get some sunflowers. I'll show you the one that doesn't look so drastic in a minute. But this one, oh, it's so beautiful. I'll show you in a minute the picture of it, but it just got eaten alive by the slugs. In the other video, this sunflower is unusual because it's got three heads. Never seen that before. So there's another one there on the same stalk. And there's a head here. So that's, it's pretty unusual, isn't it? I think. I mean, have you guys seen anything like that before? Let me know in the comments. Okay, bye-bye. So here's our back garden. And I did get a small potato crop here. I used the rabbits' hay from their cages when I was cleaning them out. And the potatoes went wild. But I didn't get... I suppose because I didn't keep fertilising them, I don't know what I did wrong, but I only got a very small crop, so I've got a video of that somewhere, which I'll try now. Here's my little robin. Hello darling, you wait for your nuts. Hello baby. Okay, I'll get you some then. I'll get you some nuts, shall I? Yes, are you missing me? I know. How are you? Love our little robin. Every morning he even flies in the house, and I crush nuts up and I put them on the table. He tells me, you know, he follows me down the garden. He's so lovely. I'm coming. I'd go I might go and get his nuts now, lovely. Poor little fish.
Crush up the nuts, it's easier for the birds to eat. I put it in a bag and I just put them on the table, and it's lovely to see them. You see so many different little birds coming to the table, and it's really nice. We love nature, my daughter and I. We sit there from the window just like, wow, isn't this lovely?
Before anybody leaves a nasty message about Jeffrey's knotweed, please read this book, Invasive Plant Medicine. Do your research, and you know, if you can help me find the four patents, the four medical patents for Jeffrey's knotweed, I'd really, really appreciate it. I'm just trying to see. So if you go to page 225, so the book is called Invasive Plant Medicine, and it's by Timothy Lee Scott. And you go to 225 in Science Studies, it mentions here, I'm just trying to find it, hang on a second. Knotweed is worthy of at least four patents. So, and also, you know, it's got resveratrol properties in it, anti-aging, which is very big now. If you check out, you know, the news and the videos, etc. And Jeffrey's knotweed has got the biggest resveratrol properties, anti-aging properties of any plant. It cures. If you go to medical use here. So, you know, it clears heat, resolves toxins, it says here, transforms phlegm, stops coughs. So that's what I'm trying with asthma. But of course, seek medical help if you guys want to do it. And I'm going to be digging up the root to see if it can help my creaking knee as well. But it does actually, they've used it to cure Lyme's disease, which is really massive in the USA, and it's turning out to be big here in the UK. So this is something that we really need to look into, discuss, debate and try. So you know, they say it's really good for arthritis. So you know, if it cures my creaking knee, then I'm gonna see if it can help my mum, my family, my friends, etc. And here's my little bookmark. I love you, Japanese knotweed. I do, I really love Japanese knotweed. I'm so, you know, you get so annoyed with these invasive plants in your garden, and then you find out about them and how good they are for you, and it just changes your whole outlook on things. This is the last of the Japanese knotweed wine. I only made two bottles, but my partner makes me giggle because he doesn't drink. He keeps swigging it. He absolutely loves it. Yeah, he hates alcohol, but he loves this stuff. It's just like really ironic. And he took it out and he sort of left it with a customer by accident. But he keeps getting people to try it because he thinks it's really amazing. So, I mean, I feel quite chuffed that he likes something that I've done. You know, I feel really impressed. And the fact that my neighbour loves this stuff means that I've done something right. And, you know, we don't really drink. But I think it's worth trying and trying different recipes of this plant. Especially if it's got resveratrol in it, you know, anti-aging. It's got to be better to have something organic. There's no pesticides used, etc. You don't need pesticides, which I think is not weed. So it's going to be better for you, isn't it, than drinking other alcohols, I would have thought. So it's something really worth looking into. First of all, I wanted to get rid of this blackberry bush because I thought, oh my gosh, it's unsightly and it's taken over the garden. Now I love it. It feeds the birds. My daughter loves the juice. I make blackberry juice with it. Blackberry lollies, etc. And it's all organic. There's no pesticides, so you know, I'm just really grateful that we've got this in our garden now. And the bees love it. I've got some wonderful pictures of the bees collecting the nectar, and their legs are full of it. It's just, I have to show you the pictures I've got. This is my little stinging nettle patch, and I use this for like creating teas, etc. For our asthma, and it's really helped. Last year my daughter and I came off our inhalers during the summer months for about 2 months, just by drinking stinging nettle tea. Well, I had stinging nettle tea, but I think you have to do it like in threes, like, you know, when you take medication you take it in threes. So I had to have it like morning, lunchtime and evening for it to actually work and keep up with it. And with my daughter, it's really strange. She had like, I gave her 2 ounces of the stinging nettle juice. I actually stuck it in the fridge and it went to a really dark colour, and I used to keep it for about 3 days and then restart another one. Because I say it sort of like keeps for about 3 days. So added 2 ounces of that cold singing little tea to 2 oranges. That seemed to keep her off the inhalers. The problem is we have is that we don't seem to be getting enough of these stinging nettles. We need more. I did try and grow some indoors, and I put them outside. What I did was over here, so it was a bit messy at the moment, but I put loads and loads of hay. It did look quite neat. Then I put some soil in there, and I planted the stinging nettles in there, but the slugs got the whole lot. So now I'm thinking I've got these stinging nettle seeds, so I'm going to try and grow some more again indoors, but keep them indoors. And just try and sort of grow them in pots. It's a bit crazy growing stinging nettles in your house, but I mean, it's just such a wonderful plant for asthma. It really is good. I mean, I'd recommend anybody on medication see a GP or, you know, a herbalist if you're going to be taking the stuff, but for us, it's just like, it's really helped us. And also, here's our wonderful plantain, and we've got dead nettle as well, which I use for like a hair rinse, and I use Japanese knotweed as a leave-in conditioning hair rinse. So we use soap nuts, which is also chemical free. They call it a nut, but really it's a berry. I'll show you that later on if I can remember. But so we use that to wash the hair, so it's not, there's no chemicals there, and then rinse it, and then we put on the dead nettle. So I just sort of boil that up for about half an hour, let it cool down, and then use it warm. You know, sip it and use it warm. But this wonderful Japanese knotweed, it's such a shame it's got such a really backlashing, you know, of negative things written about it, because it's a herbal plant, it's got 4 medical patents. I just can't understand why this information isn't getting out. So I'd love to do more research and get other people to help with this. We love it as a smoothie. We have it as a smoothie, so we have orange, like either 1 or 2 oranges with you know, one or two bananas, and then sort of like about 8 to 10 leaves. So I usually pick I usually probably go for about that size leaf, or maybe a bit smaller. For me, I go for the bigger ones, but for my daughter I go for like 8 small ones of these, and I go for like bigger ones of mine for me. So I go for bigger ones for me. Just trying to think what else I could tell you. The bees love it. Oh, it's starting to rain. So it's all starting to flower here. And you're probably thinking, oh, our neighbour's going to go mad. But our neighbours are lovely. They paint her fence every couple of years. And I've just made my neighbour some wine for doing it. He found it too dry. So I'm going to try and make him another bottle, sweeter, but his wife loves it, so I'm making some more for them to try. So yeah, the bees love this plant because it flowers when nothing else is flowering, because it's flowering in September. So that's really good. And also the good news is that this is like bamboo. So what I'm going to do, once it's all died off, I'm going to chop these all down, and I'm going to make some bee houses for them, because if you can see here, it's got these little marks here. But if you cut these to size, it's sort of I try to explain it. It's not like bamboo where it's completely hollow. These bits here, it sort of blocks it off. So you could make, like, look, if you're out and about, sort of like in the forest, you need some water. There is a video on YouTube that shows you how to make like a little water bottle out of it. It's quite fascinating. So you have to sort of poke with the bamboo, you have to poke a hole all the way through to make it one big, like, you know, hollow thing, if I'm making any sense here. I'm rambling on. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be sort of cutting loads of these and make sure they're hollow, and then I'm going to stick them into some of the trees for the bees to sort of like hide in during the winter. I love this plant, plantain. I want to try and grow these down the sides of the garden, so I'm going to put lots of hay down there. Also, I'd like to grow some wild strawberries, because they say that they need shade, so it'd be quite nice to grow a mixture of plantain and strawberries down here. And I'll put some more hay down there and some soil, etc. So yeah, this is really good for asthma. I put this, like, I make a stinging nettle and plantain tea. I find that really helps me. If I have that like 3 times a day, I don't seem to be getting like wheezy at all, like in the evenings or in the mornings, so that's a good thing. Because I mean, there's so much rubbish in our food today, isn't there? All these chemicals, preservatives that are toxic, etc. So we really need to try and, I want to sort of try and liaise with people who do home growing in the Swansea area, like swap and trade things if I can. I think that would be really great, a really neat idea, and trying to encourage other people to try and grow little bits and pieces, because I think we need to have some sort of good foods in our system. Even this like dandelion, I'd like to grow more of these. This woman's a nutter. It's a weed. No, but this has got really good herbal properties as well, and people make, I think they make it into coffee, the root into coffee, and they also make tea with it from the flower and the leaf, but do your research on it. I have actually made tea from the flowers, and it's quite okay, it's quite nice. But the rabbits love this stuff, so you know, it'd be nice to sort of grow a lot for these, for the rabbits as well. I might even start eating this and plantain instead of kale, because apparently the organic, the big organic companies, they use, they're using like copper, is it, or something like that. But there are videos on YouTube saying that, you know, the big organic companies are using things, is it worth buying organic foods because they're, you know, they're more toxic than other foods. So I don't know, it sort of really sort of makes you question things. I think you're better off growing your own food if you can. I know it's difficult because, well, it's time, isn't it? We don't have much time these days, we're so busy just trying to earn money. So yeah, so if you can get to, if you can eat your weeds, well, they're not really weeds, I don't like to call them weeds, I like to call them herbs. They are herbs. It's better for you. There's no chemicals. They don't need chemicals, they just grow, don't they? They just grow everywhere, which is great. I just need more of them, that's all. And a greenhouse here, where the trampoline is, and just move the rabbit run. We got this rabbit, I know it's all done slightly with the money, we get it all tidied up. But it's been a bit of a tough time. Families, you know, families are struggling at the moment. All families are struggling with this economy at the moment. So, yeah, so a greenhouse there. And then that Wendy house, you know, just hoping to get some money together to sort of get it fixed so we can put the rabbits out there, because at the moment they're in the house and, you know, that's sort of affecting us because the food creates the allergies. And then, you know, then we get the pet allergies because of the food, so it's like a vicious circle. So if we could get the rabbits out of the house and into the Wendy house, that would be brilliant. And then just have the run, you know, so they've got lots of space to run in the garden. We'd like to have the run sort of like the whole length of the garden, and at the moment they keep escaping, the little devils. So, you know, they'd be jumping the fence, so we need to sort of like really get it set up properly. So, and also they need to get them neutered, because we don't want more bunnies. We've already got, how many have we got now? Six. We did have 10. I think we had 10 of them. Four of them died. The little babies died, poor little things. But yeah, but they're great. Rabbits are absolutely great for organic growing. I think, you know, as long as you treat them nicely. I've seen these videos on YouTube where they don't treat them very nicely. I'll have to show you that if I can remember. But, you know, they're picking them up by the ears. It's horrible. You know, it's really sad. I mean, we've got, like, a little rabbit hutch down there so they can hide from the cats in there. And they love it out here. Encourage the bumblebees and the butterflies into our gardens. So we've got quite a few buddleias. They're dying off now, but I've got some pictures of them where they're all in lovely bloom. I mean, this, I don't know if they go for this one. It's not much on it. And they do. But the white ones, this is a white one, you can't see it now, but they love this one, they really like this one, and they like the purple one there. I believe we've still got some flowers on the Lavateria in September. Absolutely love this plant. I mean, it flowers best probably about June time is when you get the best flowers, and I love picking them and putting them in the house because they're so beautiful. I actually gave my dad I sent him a cutting for Father's Day in the post last year. When was Father's Day? I can't remember if it was April or June. But anyway, What he did was he actually, because he's a gardener himself, and he's been a gardener, he's retired now, but he's been a gardener, you know, throughout his working life, really. He used to work for the council as well. But what he did was he actually, I think he put it into a greenhouse. He put some root powder on or something like that, put it into a greenhouse, and then he planted it out in the garden. It's now 5 foot tall. That's not bad, is it? For, you know, a cutting, that's great. So if anybody wants any cuttings of the Lavateria, you're most welcome. And this is where we buried little baby bunnies. He's tidying up here. But, so there's four little baby bunnies in there, and, you know, this is a lovely little plant. I'm not allowed to pick the flowers from this. Melody will go absolutely hysterical. I did pick some. And she said, "Mum, mustn't do that. It's the baby's plant." So, it's quite sweet. It's a beautiful plant. And it, you know, it really took off this year, which is lovely because just reminds us of the little rabbits. My friend has had a wonderful crop of tomatoes this year by planting them in hanging baskets. Now, because I planted one in here, or a couple in here, and I have got some tomatoes growing on there. I don't know if you can see them. Can you see them if I zoom in? There you go. There are some tomatoes on here. Not get much light because I can't remember what this plant's called. It's really pretty. It smells lovely. I can't remember what it's called. Anyway, so it's not getting a lot of light there. So great to get some hanging baskets, you know, over here, hanging down there or something like that. Stop the snails getting to them. So that's probably all I've got to... Oh, hang on a second, I've missed my sunflower that's still alive and kicking. All the rest have been eaten alive. So here we go. Oh, look at this, it's exciting. Looks like it's going to flower. What I've been doing, I'm amazed it's still going actually. Maybe the slugs are waiting for it to flower before they attack. I mean, the leaves have been nibbled on, something chronic. But it's done well in this pot, I've got to say. I keep chucking garlic in there, so I don't know if that's having any effect of it not getting destroyed by the slugs and the snails. I don't know. You know, what are your thoughts on this? Let me know. This is our little lemon tree that Melody and I grew from seed. She took the husk off with her nails and she put it into some kitchen roll with some distilled water, just damp kitchen roll, wrapped it in tin film. We put it away for a while in a dark cupboard and it started to sprout, and then we just planted it and it's doing really well. So really proud of that. It's just so lovely to be able to grow things from seed. No, it's fascinating. It feel like you've achieved something, you feel closer to nature, so we love it. So if there are any gardeners out there in the Swansea area, worldwide, that would love to talk to me, I'd love to talk to you, share stories, try and share seeds, cuttings, just drop me a message in the comments. And if there's anybody chucking out some greenhouses in the Swansea area in Wales, UK, please think of me, because I'd really love them, and I'm happy to share the harvest with you for the first year. And I really hope to get a really good harvest next year if I can get hold of some greenhouses. And if people are throwing out any old pots, you know, big pots, I'd love to, you know, please send them to me, or, you know, give them to me if you can, if you're in the local area. I'd love them. That, you know, like most families, you've had a tough year, so any support would really, really appreciate it. And I just hope that I can one day, you know, get something together with my MP to help families earn from home with no fees, with a website, earning money through selling old and new things. And, you know, and do the organic gardening on there as well. And send downloads of original songs, ebooks, templates, etc. I just think that this would be a wonderful thing worldwide, to have a family-orientated website that helps families all across the globe
and it's something that I'm looking into, and I'd really love support and help to get our governments to, you know, help us get this off the ground, because I feel they owe us big time. We've got, you know, food banks, you know, so many people using food banks, we've got people starving in different countries. You know, we need to sort of try to act as team players to help one another and get this country, our world, to the place we need it to be. And to, you know, organic gardening is so exciting because it's helping our planet and it's getting communities together and people together and just creating a happier, nicer place to live in. And here is my sweet potato plant that I didn't get in the ground. But, you know, I've achieved something here, you know. I did this with carrots as well. I managed to grow some carrots indoors, get the roots going and plant them outside, but the slugs got them. So, but never mind. You just have to keep with what you can do. So I'm going to stick to tomatoes and strawberries. Okay, so this is my avocado plant. I'm really proud of this. I've grown this from seed by wrapping it in kitchen roll, you know, damp kitchen roll, and then put it into a bag and then just letting it sort of like root. And then I put it into some water here, and then it starts growing some roots. I don't know if you can see. Probably need to change the water in here actually. And then I put it in the pot, and so I've got two going. Actually, I've got three going. So I'm really proud. So I'm doing something right there. So if I can get more going, maybe you can do some seed swaps with these, because I do eat a lot of avocados, because I don't eat meat, etc. So if anybody's interested, let me know. I forgot to say they are organic, not that I don't know if that matters anymore after watching these organic things, but I think it's up to you to sort of make the choice. Just having a little cuddle. Here we've got little Aragon. There's a brown bunny. We found out it's a girl recently. And Legolas is cuddling Aragon. Oh, they're so sweet. Oh, I want to get a picture. Did you get a picture?
Yeah.
There's Patch. Hi, Patchy. You're feeling left out, my darling. Don't worry, you can cuddle later. So that's all from me. Sorry if I rambled on a bit, but my name's Sharon J. Bainbridge, and this is my Butterfly Lullaby book. It's a long story to this, where the elite destroyed my business, and I'm not trading because of it. So I've got my website, but I can't even use it. So it's a long story, I won't go into it. But anyway, as you can see, I love butterflies. So I'm going to see if I can add more things to this video for you to see, like the sunflowers before they died. I got eaten by the slugs. Please leave me a comment. I'd love to talk to everybody that does organic gardening, that's into curing themselves with herbs, etc. And anybody that's got Lyme disease, that's been using Japanese knotweed to cure it, I'd love to hear from you. So leave me a comment below, and let's get some discussions going. This is my Butterfly Lullaby trademark. I started trading back in 2007, I think it was, when I sort of launched my book Butterfly Lullaby at the Dylan Thomas Centre. And this is my trademark here. And this was meant to actually protect my business, my book, our songs, etc. And it didn't. And the thing that really, really annoys me is that I paid £300 for this trademark, and they're now asking for £1,320, which proves that this business is worth money, yet I can't trade because of the elite bullies. So I am going to be having a meeting with my MP about this, because I'm just not standing for this bullying, this elite bullying. I've just had enough of it. I feel that, you know, these rich people think they can just treat us like dirt and something needs to be done. So I'm going to be seeing my MP about what's happened to my business, how I got ripped off by my bank, and, you know, how families need support here. We need our banking system changed completely, because it only sort of focuses on helping the elite. And if you look at, like, Amazon, businesses like Amazon, they get away with not paying any tax, and then, you know, they're really wealthy, rich people, that somebody like me or you
we get taken to the cleaners. You know, I've had to give up my company because I got fined for late accounts when I was struggling financially, and that I had my website attacked, etc. And Cummings House were absolute nasty people. They had, you know, they let Amazon off, yet somebody like me that needs support, they make me close my business down, otherwise they're going to fine me lots of money. So I am going to be complaining to my MP, and if anybody out there's had the same sort of problem with these elite people that just, you know, tread all over you, they destroy your business, your family life, etc., you know, leave me a message below, because I'd love to hear from you, share your stories, and, you know, together we can change the system. So wish me luck with my MP, and I'm going to be taking him some Japanese knotweed wine. So I'm brewing some up now for Christmas. So I'm also, you know, I promised to make him some videos. I'm just going to take some videos down. I'll give him some videos to watch before I go down to have another meeting with him. Because I want to get a website up for families, a free website to help them earn from home. Because our kids want their parents at home. And if, you know, not everybody wants to work from home, but the parents that do, and they want to be their kids, then that should be there for them. They shouldn't have to pay for it. So wish me luck. And if anybody wants to come with me to my MP, I live in the Swansea area. I'd love to have you on board. I'm a team player, so yeah, hope to hear from you. Leave me a comment and speak soon. Have a lovely day. Bye-bye.
Shoo-ba-doo-ah, shoo-ba-doo-ah, ba-ba-oo. Never, never, never.